Hello, 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 and welcome back to our YouTube channel. We are so happy that you have clicked in to get these nuggets on the budget that got us out of debt, where the only liabilities or debts that we have right now is a mortgage and one car payment and one student loan. Come on now. Then we were able to save money for our daughter to go off to college. We were able to put a specific amount of money into a savings account set aside just to be used for her tuition so that she won't have to get loans while she's in college. And then we were also able to take some vacations. We were able to take a number of family cruises, not just for Oliver and I, but for he and I and our three girls. We were able to go on multiple cruises over the last several years and take different trips to various states for things like to run a race. We would just go to a different state that we had never been to, run a race, and come back home. All of that costs money, right? But we were able to do that once we started using a budget and we used one that worked for us. So let's just jump right into it. And that is a zero-based budget. What that means is that you are accounting for all of your income and you are accounting for all of your expenses. And so you account for certain things within a line item where you're able to say this much to groceries, this much to tithes, this much to housing, this much to transportation, this much to hair care, this much to school supplies, this much to anniversaries. And you really dictate the different line items and make sure that every dollar has a home. This is your roadmap where you are literally telling your money where to go. Think about driving down the road. We keep talking about this analogy that your money is, or like your budget rather, is like a roadmap. The reason that is, it's because you get the ability, you have the ability to tell your money where to go. And so what you want to do with a budget is have these line items that are just like a roadmap. And I'm sure you've seen them. When you're taking a road trip and you pull out the map and you're like, oh my gosh, there are so many options. There are so many little roads. It helps you figure out detours. It helps you figure out how to navigate, how to shift when you need to shift. That's what the zero-based budget does. It is detailed, and so it does take some time to set up at first, but once you get it, it's like popcorn. It just keeps popping and you keep rolling. And so what you want to do is itemize everything that you're spending, and you want to make sure that at the very end, you have a zero balance. And so I mentioned these line item budgeted suggestions, but you also have the opportunity to pay yourself first because you account for things like savings as a line item. You account for things like allowance as a line item, things such as retirement as a line item. And because you're accounting for them in this zero-based budget spreadsheet or worksheet, then you have the ability and you have the opportunity to go ahead and control your spending, still pay yourself first, but still zero it out to make sure that there's still enough money in other areas. And so I mentioned a limitation about that one earlier, and it's you may spend so much paying yourself first that you really don't know where the rest is going. Well, what happens in a zero-based budget is that you adjust the numbers accordingly so that every dollar is spent and you can't go over because you have to end in zero. You can't end in negative because you can't spend what you don't have, right? And so you just adjust the numbers accordingly. That's part of the benefit. We talked a little bit about an envelope system. And so the way you would incorporate an envelope system into this particular setup is you have certain items that you know are going to be paid with an online piece of technology. And so you account for those in a line item based on the amount that you know is going to be withdrawn from your account. But then there are certain other things that are different expenses. And so they may, you're not exactly sure how much you're going to spend. So some examples would be groceries, gas, and fast food. Very easy examples. So you take a certain amount of cash and you throw it in an envelope for groceries. You take another amount and you throw it in for gas. You take another amount and you throw it in for whatever other areas you have. That is the amount of money that you then have to take to the store with you to spend. So you've put it in your line item under your zero-based budget in order to accommodate or account for that amount of money. And once the money in the envelope is gone, it's gone. And you hope that you have some PB&J in a cabinet and that you still have something to eat until you get paid. But my point is, you can still incorporate that cash budgeting concept within a zero-based budgeting, because once you have played with the numbers and adjusted them to get your budget to zero, then whatever number is in that line item in that zero-based budget, you pull that amount out in cash, you stick it in an envelope, and you just operate with that. Now, yes, that is one extra step because it requires you to go to the bank, but it is an amazing step for those who are getting started with getting up and getting out. The last one that we talked about that can be incorporated into the zero-based budget is that proportional budget. And that's when you've taken a certain percentage of your income to pay for certain things. And you can still do that in this budget and the various ways that I've already explained. You just decide what the proportion is going to be and you adjust accordingly. If you are looking for some ideas of what that zero-based budget looks like because you're ready to get started, go ahead and in the comments is going to be a link for you to opt in to get a freebie from us. And we would love to send you some paperwork on how you can get started, and we want to get you on your way. We are also happy to schedule a breakthrough strategy session, and you can see that link here, where you can go ahead and jump on a phone call with us and let us give you some practical tips based on your situation. We don't believe that budgets can be a one size fits all for everybody. So we are happy to speak to you about what we recommend to work specifically for you and specifically for your situation. I want you to drop any questions that you might have that we can answer for you in future videos. We hope that you have gotten something from this. If you did, be sure to hit the subscribe button because we don't want you to miss any future videos. We have a lot of information to share. You can also join us on our social media channels. We're on YouTube and Facebook under Regroup for Change LLC. And we want to make sure that we are helping you to create financial peace in your home so that you can do things like save money, pay for vacations, travel the world, and pay down debt. The world is your oyster. Let's go get it. Peace.